root word or word root. So root word and word root explain number of carbons in a chain, how many number of carbons are present. That is explained by a root word or word root. So in that, we consider number of carbons. And the next one, root word. So what is the root word for that one? Or word root. If it is number of carbons are 1, means C1, means the number of carbons are 1, that root word is meat. If the number of carbons are 2, that is eat. If it is 3, that is probe. If the number of carbons are 4, that root word is bute. If it is 5 carbons are present, that is pent. If it is 6 carbons, X. If it is 7 carbons, apt. If it is 8 carbons, oct. If it is 9 carbons, nona. If it is 10 carbons, dec. Okay. If it is 11 carbons, 12 carbons, we consider different names. So no need for intermediate syllabus. So number of carbons are meat, eat, probe, bute, pent, ex, ept, oct, non, dec. Means your number of carbons are 5. The root word is C5, that is pent. So these are the root word. Means root word is explained how many number of carbon atoms are present in a parent chain. That is called as root word or word root. And now, in this root word, after completion of root word, if you consider another one, third step, there is suffix. So this suffix, the suffix is explained nature of functional group. It explains nature of functional group and the nature of it containing double bonds or triple bond, means nature of functional group and saturated. The given compound is saturated or unsaturated. Okay, that is explained by a suffix. It is mainly explained by functional group information. Which type of functional group is present in a parent carbon? That is explained by a suffix. Here suffixes are classified into two types. These are classified into two types. They are, in that first one, A, primary suffix. And next one is secondary suffix. Primary suffix and next one is secondary suffix. This primary suffix. So the primary suffix is explained. That is what saturation. The given organic compound is saturated organic compound or unsaturated organic compound. Means if it is saturated organic compound, the saturated organic compounds all are containing single bonds. So single bonds means those are containing which bonding is present here? Only sigma bond is present. Only sigma bond is present, that is a saturated compound. The saturated compound example is, we already discussed, that is alkane. Now unsaturated compounds. The unsaturated compounds means these are containing double bonds. Generally double bonds and triple bonds are present. If it is double bond is present, such compounds are called as alkenes. If it is triple bond is present, such organic compounds are called as alkynes. So this is our primary suffix. Only the primary suffix is explained. In between the carbon, single bond is present or double bond or triple bond. So what type of bond is present? That is explained by a primary suffix. So that may be like this, C bond C or C double bond C or C triple bond C. And next one is secondary suffix. So next one, secondary suffix. This secondary suffix is explain nature of functional group. Okay, so which type of functional group is present in parent carbon is explained by a secondary suffix. For example, your functional group name, next one is structure. So what is the structure of that functional group? And next one is secondary suffix. So what is the name of that secondary suffix? We are discussing this one. In this, if it is functional group, if it is the functional group name is alkyl halide, so this alkyl halide structure is RX. Here R indicates alkyl, X is your halogen, that is a halide, alkyl halide. Whenever the alkyl halides are present, its secondary suffix is haloalkane. Haloalkane means alkyl halides are derived from which compounds? Alkanes. Means alkyl halides are your daughter, its parent carbon is your haloalkanes, its parent carbon is alkane. So secondary suffix is alkane. And next one, if you consider aldehydes, so the aldehyde structure is, general formula is CHO. So its secondary suffix is al, propanol, butanol, or methanol, ethanol, propanol, butanol, pentanol, hexanol. Means your suffix is, secondary suffix is al. If you appear, and next one is ketone. If it is a ketone is a functional group, its structure is C double bond O. So for this one, the secondary suffix is known. Now applied ethan, propanone, butanone, pentanone, hexanone, means your secondary suffix is known. So whereas aldehyde is al. For example, next one, hydroxy. If it is hydroxy group is act as a functional group, means so nothing but your alcohols. So that structure is OH. Here secondary suffix is ol, propanol, ol, or butanol, or pentanol. Means your suffix you have written, last one is ol. But here al, propanol, propanol, butanol, butanol, like that. Or if you next one, ester. So if ester group is act as a functional group, its ester formula is COOR. Okay, here R is nothing but again alkyl group. If it is alkyl group is present, this ester secondary suffix is OAT or OATE. Means methanoate, propanoate, butanoate, pentanoate, like that. Or if it is carboxylic acid, if the carboxylic acid is act as a functional group, its structure is COOH. Okay, its secondary suffix is oic acid. Means again same, methanoic acid, ethanoic acid, propanoic acid, means here suffix is oic acid. Okay, like that. Or if you consider another one, sulfonic acid. Okay, sulfonic acid, if the functional group name is sulfonic acid, its structure is SO3H. okay, its secondary suffix is sulfone. Its secondary suffix is sulfone, like that. Or next one, if you consider another one, if the secondary suffix is your aldehydes, ketones, hydroxy, ester, carboxylic acids, all are completed. Next one is, if it is nitrile group, so cyanide. The cyanide group is present, its structure is CN. Its secondary suffix is nitrile. Its secondary suffix is nitrile. Nitromethane or alkyne methyl nitrile or ethyl nitrile or propyl nitrile. That is what means here nitrile is addition with your suffix. Okay, so these are the suffix. Means secondary suffix is especially explain nature of functional group. So these are the important terms. Okay, so this is your nomenclature of organic compounds. Means IUPAC means International Union Pure Applied Chemistry is involved for nomenclature of organic compounds involving three steps. One is prefix, root word and suffix. Prefix explain nature of carbons and nature of substituent. Root word explain number of carbons in a parent carbon. And suffix explain nature of functional groups and double bond or triple bond. And the arrangement of this one. So what is the order for representation of nomenclature of organic compounds? In that, if you generally write, first one is prefix and follows word root and suffix. But in prefix there are two types. One is primary prefix and secondary prefix. In that, first write secondary prefix. So what is your secondary prefix is there? You write secondary prefix after the completion of secondary prefix, you can write primary prefix. And then after root word, and after that one, if you write your in these two your first write again, first write primary prefix means primary suffix, and last one is secondary suffix. So means the functional group information you should write always last word. So secondary suffix. So this is the order. First one is secondary prefix, follows primary prefix, next root word and primary suffix and secondary suffix. Generally in prefixes, where numerical numbers and number of prefixes are present, and similarly in suffix also numerical numbers and number suffix are present. So this is your nomenclature of organic compounds.